Welcome to UFIFA's Tropical Research and Education Center website. My name is Gil Evans and I serve as the director of the center. Our center is an integral part of the University of Florida, and we are extremely proud to be one of the only state-supported university facility conducting research on a wide range of tropical and subtropical crops and natural resources. Our unique work helps to extend the impact of the university throughout the world. Since the establishment of TREC in 1929, we have partnered with the local community to provide science-based solutions to many of the challenges impacting South Florida farmers. Our goal is to support and advance agriculture while simultaneously protecting and conserving Florida's valuable natural resources. It is a complex job, but our world-renowned scientists are up to the task. We invite you to explore our website and then visit our center to learn more about the remarkable work being done here and how TREC can help you. Thank you for visiting our website, and we hope to see you real soon.
Opened in 1929, the UFIFAS Tropical Research and Education Center, or TREC, sits just 30 miles south of Miami, but a world away from the city. Here, in this unique subtropical environment, 18 faculty members and more than 130 staff, support scientists and students, work on both basic and applied research. Their mission is to develop and disseminate science-based information to agricultural producers, natural resource managers, and residents. The goal is to protect Florida's natural resources while working to improve the productivity and efficiency of South Florida farmers so both areas can continue to contribute to the state's economy. The location of the center allows researchers to work closely with farmers in the four traditional areas important to South Florida agriculture: tropical fruit, vegetable, ornamental, and natural resources. Together, the industries served by TREC have an annual farm gate value of $800 million and an annual economic impact on the local economy of over $1.7 billion. But TREC is also branching out beyond these traditional agricultural industries. These new areas of research will help South Florida farmers and residents adapt to the changing environment and allow agricultural producers to stay competitive in domestic and foreign markets today and in the future. At TREC, a team of entomologists, plant breeders, and plant pathologists works each day to find solutions to the challenges facing farmers. Entomologists are working on ways to battle ambrosia beetles to keep the Florida $100 million a year avocado industry in business. They're developing solutions for the whiteflies, scale insects, and bud weevils attacking ornamental plants grown in local nurseries. And they're studying the biology of thrips to better minimize the impact of these damaging insects on vegetable crops like peppers. Plant breeders work to develop new varieties of traditional and non-traditional fruit and vegetable crops with superior characteristics like better flavor, increased yield, and disease resistance. In papaya, breeders are creating varieties with resistance to debilitating ring spot virus. These new varieties could allow fresh papaya to be produced in Florida that could compete with imported ones. Plant pathologists are combating diseases such as blight and bacterial spot while simultaneously working to identify the next disease threat coming to Florida's shores. New pests and diseases can come in through the numerous ports in Florida, and some show up at the TREC Plant Diagnostic Clinic. Here, farmers can bring in plant samples for analysis and advice from UFIFAS experts. The plant clinic is what first brought Mark Wilson to the center. Wilson is the president of Greendale Nursery, and he turned to TREC for help when he developed a problem with his heliconia plants. After trying unsuccessfully to solve the problem on his own, he came to the clinic.
So I took it over, and I was showing them the problem, and they've seen it before. You know, being an educator and being in touch with other people all over the world, you come across these things. So they looked at it and they were able to quickly analyze it and say, why don't you try this? That's what we did, and it worked out very well. People don't realize how important TREC has been, not only to the agricultural industry, but to the community at large.
The clinic is just one example of how TREC is meeting the changing needs and challenges of the agriculture industry. New research with drones is helping farmers reduce their water use and conserve this precious natural resource. And at the new biogeochemistry lab, TREC scientists operate the Membrane Inlet Mass Spectrometer, or MIMS. This unique machine measures the amount of gas, like nitrogen, that is found in soil and water samples. The goal is to help farmers reduce fertilizer runoff, help scientists to mitigate nitrogen already found in coastal ecosystems, and to help everyone understand how to adapt to the impacts of climate change and sea level rise. Growers understand that adapting to environmental change is critical for the survival of their industry. Eric Teague is a second-generation farmer. His mother started Pine Island Nursery in 1972 and began working with TREC to help keep her in business, even as her business changed from growing citrus to tropical fruit trees and ornamentals.
We can no longer really rely on and grow the same crops that our parents or grandparents, or in some cases our great-grandparents, you know, once grew. A lot of those are just antiquated and are no longer economically competitive with both domestic and, of course, foreign competitors at the same time.
In order to meet the changing needs of South Florida farmers, UF IFAS researchers are growing test plots of industrial hemp, vanilla plants, and new varieties of pumpkins for the oil from their seeds. These new avenues of agriculture could help traditional farmers stay in business and bring new business to the South Florida economy. The goal for this research is to learn how to grow these crops in this unique environment and then pass this knowledge along to growers. These test plots and early studies allow researchers to make mistakes now so that farmers won't make them in the future. After 90 years, the Tropical Research and Education Center in Homestead has seen a lot of change. But some things will never change at TREC. There will always be world-class research and extension faculty working to support and improve Florida agriculture and natural resources. There will always be experts living and working in South Florida alongside the farmers and natural resource agencies that they serve. And there will always be a focus at TREC on providing excellence in tropical horticulture and natural resource management, and a commitment to solving the problems facing Florida's residents.
We will definitely continue to have problems. I think as time goes on, the growers in the industry will become increasingly more reliant on the science that comes out of TREC.
Without TREC, we would not be able to sustain the level of agriculture we have today.
The next 90 years will bring more changes and more challenges, but the UF IFAS Tropical Research and Education Center is ready for the future.